Balkunam.
Praise the Lord.
Likiwena mas sheba.
Check your Bibles.
Ya shamati winam neba pam jomso.
It is good for the people of God to be led.
Sankani win tudum kaye.
Otherwise, there is no religion.
Sankani tumin kaye.
Otherwise, there is no work.
Ya jomso pouin.
It is a teaching
that
someone can adore God and serve Him.
Ya jumso pouin.
It is in teachings
that someone
can choose to walk with God.
Because
you have learned and then have seen.
Le rieta mti chemin fatonde contre jumso se kien wenam baraka pouso.
Therefore, every week we have been giving you teachings concerning the work, the word of God.
When woman prophecy, ajuji yele yele ya.
God prophesies about Jesus saying,
"For whom Israel lakashekye."
As you are lifting up Israel is not enough.
Na kitem te yidunu afanvena.
I will allow you to be the light of the whole world.
Dung una mana bunkong na bahno.
But God have done so in Navasnogu.
Nyamshe kontwinam gwama ibebi yeshuka kashekye.
As you are sharing the word of God among your brethren is not enough.
Emek them that a king do not yet far to never liaison.
We allow you to go all over the world for the people to receive our teachings.
But I wanna meela is it to remember.
But God told Isaiah to tell the people
the bam walk of gwama
that he have honored his word.
That
he allow you to be great.
The bandit hand power me.
If someone mock of it,
Bamwo,
you have already honored his word. And his word is great. And those who are trying to receive it, if you receive a greater thing, you become greater. But those who refuse to receive the word, it is difficult for them to be great. We have learned about them talking about it.
Pastor better.
Great pastors.
Tuntum better.
Then a great workers of God.
Yeah, when I'm going,
it is because of the word of God.
As you
have received the word, and because of that, you have become great.
That
is why they are talking about
it. Therefore,
if you receive the word of God,
and
you do as according to what the God is
saying,
it is by all means that a composite that they will talk about you
everywhere.
God is with this woman.
And when I'm being in Rosala,
God is with this man.
Then no one am I.
And those who love God say,
when I'm having any other, maybe
if God is with someone, I'm also with him.
Yampanyende.
Have you seen?
Yeah, yeah. What me? Yeah, when yeah, tuntum kasanga.
That is the reason why someone can become a great servant of God.
Laha ni when I'm daba.
According to the will of God.
Of that time, he am for you better.
He want all of you to be great.
Because
his word coming out from his mouth, it belongs to him. It belongs to him.
You
know, concerning the presidents of this world, if they call someone and tell him, I want you to be a president. And then to command all of the people. But it is because it is the people who have chosen me
to
own them.
And I
am choosing you
for
you to use to lead them. Whether it is a minister that the president called and then you have chosen him. In that moment, as you have received the word of the president, immediately all the soldiers will be with him. That they should go and guard him. They should guard his works. Because you have received the word of the president. And all the population are with him. Because the president has given him the
authority.
And we are with the president. But if it happened that
a woman being
can give his fellow an authority and he can become great. Truly. If the children of God receive the word of God, which is above the word of a woman,
Are
they not talking about you?
But
you have received, you have rejected.
They
don't accept.
Don't
that our enemy.
It is
that power that have prevented us from accepting the word of God.
It is
that is our enemy.
Otherwise,
there is nobody.
The
imagination in your life,
and
you are in the church without growing,
and
you don't accept,
you are
not producing like a tree.
We are
supposed to fight against that thing
so
that it will help us.
We are
in the time of thanksgiving.
There
is a lot of people that God has given them a billions.
But
they don't know how to thank God. If you ask them, they didn't teach us.
I thought
that it was my knowledge that gave me the money.
I don't know
that it is God who helped me to get my
certificate. The
time I was studying, if I listen,
and then
he will put the thing in my mind.
But
whenever they ask
me, what
was in my mind will manifest.
And then I
will give the answer to those who ask me.
And
then they will give me a certificate
that
I am champion.
And then
they have chosen me to work.
I don't know
that it is God who have already put in the word in my mind.
So that
those words will bring the money.
Had I known,
I would have thanked God with all my heart.
Because
you have put in his word in
the
and then that word bring up the
diploma
and he bring works
and
he bring money.
Barakwena.
Praise the Lord.
He said they
should teach the people.
They
did not come into this word by their own.
Therefore,
if you have your Bibles with you there,
let's go to Psalm 21,
verse
1.
That we are going to read.
Psalm
21,
verse 1.
Someone who praised God because you have delivered him from the hands of the enemy. In chapter 2.
Jusheba Rimanamana Shunuru Yampangaying.
The king shall joy in the strength, O Lord.
Layam Fara Ying
and shall rejoice.
Yina Kidma Wusuru
that have given him his heart.
Yam Koyinda Ashurendata.
Thou have given him his heart's desire.
Layam Kazara Yenur Shenkoye.
And not withholding the request of his lips. For thou preventest him with the blessings of
goodness. Thou
settest a crown of pure gold on his head. He asks life of thee, and thou givest in him even length of days forever and ever. It is a long vie without season. His glory is great in thy salvation. Thou have honored and majesty has thou laid upon him.
For thou
have made him most blessed forever.
And
thou have made him exceeding glad with thy
countenance.
For the king trusted in the Lord.
And
through the mercies of the Most High, he shall not be moved.
Nyamuna ampa manye bia ba fa.
Thy hand shall find out all thine enemies.
Nyamnugudito na ampa manye kisigitiba.
Thy right hand shall find out those that hate him.
Nyamsam puki inenga ina kitame tibam yiwa wung bugum.
Thou shalt make them as a fury even in the time of thine anger.
Jisobana mensa bamba of shuyikre poa.
The Lord shall swallow them up in his wrath.
Edna kitamti vena kangali to atir puhu nambarako.
We want this revelation to lead us to the thanksgiving.
Bolo David.
The kind of call that he called David.
Kelea bol kangbala.
It is that same call.
Lapsum bol lapla parabo.
That is calling women and men.
Sheening lapsum bola David in Peter.
The kind of spirit that was filled with in David.
Chetia shikang labna ning yam pusongwa.
It is that same spirit that will be putting in you.
Donka wena matoa.
It is not different God.
Chetia tunu.
It is our God, which is the God of David. They told us
that David bangabum talinyoto.
David knows what is profitable to him. Then he used it for thanksgiving. David did not see the faith of God. He heard only hear about his name.
That
he have seen his works. As you have seen how he created the world. With this, the king believed in God, and then that led him to thank him. In his word, he said, the king will rejoice. Because of thy strength. And because thou hast saved him. I will be glad. Do you think that someone can be worried and then get this kind of heart? Someone can be attached to the word and still have this kind of imaginations. It is difficult. The king said, I will rejoice because of the strength of God.
There
is no one that can be praising someone who has money and who is rich, and then he will hear that he is in trouble, and then he will not come and rescue him. The King David said, I will rejoice because of my salvation. It is someone who acknowledged that he was in a deep trouble. And then that problem was attached with death. And then he had delivered him. And then he thought about it and then he began to praise God. That was the King David. He was dead. And then they have saved you.
Forgetting view.
And then you are still living. After that salvation, you tied yourself with worries. Even if you are thanking God, it is only with your lips. The heart is not along with the mouth. The heart is not with the praises. And if God sees, but it is only your lips that is thanking him and then your heart is apart, you don't receive such a thanksgiving. They told the generation of Isaiah, you are approaching me with your mouth, but your heart is far, far away from me. If not God, who can see this? Someone laughing with you, and then he will greet you, and his heart is far away from you. It is only God who can see this. There is a people living like this. Their mouth is speaking about God. But their hearts are far away from God. If not that, they will quit this that place. It will be difficult for God to help them. Because this is not a love, a fidelity love. I will glad. I will rejoice because that has given me the desire of my heart. You didn't refuse, so my heart desire. This is enough for me to thank you. It is enough. This is what God is looking from us. If someone is praising God, it is disturbing the kingdom of
death.
If someone is praising God, God will bend down to look at that person. The word of God declared that in that time his face will be shining like the sun. And if he will begin to bend down and look at someone who is praising him, and then the shine of his face will dismiss the darkness. And then he will dismiss all the sickness. And then he will dismiss all corruptions. And then dismiss all poverty. That is what thanking, praising, and thanking God. That is what it can cause.
Ben Israel.
Even in human beings.
Yamham Bwala Yula.
If you call his name,
I shock them.
He will respond.
Lewunim na
nenga anti simbolo. And then he will turn his face towards where the call is coming from.
Tipka gumwena ninga ya pang saba.
Not talking about the most powerful God.
Yamham Bwala.
When you called him. With true and with faith and truthful. And then you honor him again. He will turn and look at you. Who is that child calling me? And he is praising me. You have caused trouble to the kingdom of darkness. Because his face shines. And you called him with faith, and he turned to look at you. Your enemies that are in darkness, they will perish. And they said, we should praise God. Rejoice in the time of thanksgiving. So that all the program of your devil, of the devil, of your enemies will dismiss. That is better than worries.
David vima yishom.
The life of David was good. He told God, you meet me with blessed things. You have crowned me with a golden crown.
Halal.
Which is true.
David was good.
The time that David was speaking like this, the golden crown was not yet come on him. But David foreseen heavens. Any golden crown that God has put for someone who is saved, he will use it for thanksgiving. Even though he hasn't yet crowned it. Put it on his head.
Yeah, tip I kick lion.
It is a great faith.
Hein?
Yes.
Je mentionne agent for an entity for royal shanum.
Rejoice about heaven because you will one day go there and then your room will be filled with
footable ne fournage chair shanum.
Your table and then your chair will be a good.
Good food.
Waiting for you there.
To for jenkism ka.
That you have started rejoicing on this
poor baraka.
Thanking God.
No, I'm cutting it for an interior.
Oh, they will surely say you are a righteous one.
But think it for tea them ye.
They will say that you are a believer.
Rejoice,
you know. Meanwhile, you haven't seen
the
thing. Knowing that God cannot lie. And then you are rejoicing. They will say you are a true believer. Don't you see the difference in believing, the different kinds of faith? The king said, I ask you for life, for a life. And you have given him a long life forever. The king teaches us the benefit of prayer. He has life. And God was happy. And then he gave him an eternal life. Is prayer not good? He has life. And then the king of life said, as you are on this earth having that life, with my power, it is, no matter how it is, that power will finish. That life will finish, but I will give you long life. You will reach that city that no one dies. And in that city there is no grief. There is no sickness in that city. That is what I have given to you. It is a request of faith. We are only asking for what will help us on this earth. Ask for what is ahead. And rejoice for what is ahead. That there is a profit there. If you don't rejoice for what is ahead, what you are looking here, that worries will destroy the one you are looking ahead. Because you are living a country here or that is filled with thief. Filled with jealousy. And then they are killing themselves with corruption. And then fighting with weapons. And meanwhile, you are looking for riches here. And more than what you are eating. And you are not strong enough to resist the weapons of your enemies. It is by almost that God will judge between if he get what he's looking for. Is it true that he will be able to walk according to the word of God so that his enemy will be disappointed? He will not raise up himself above the word of God. And what the enemies can cause will reach him. God, he judges all.
In a hand palm.
So if someone is rich, if God gives someone riches, as he was wearing the set of humility, he will remove it and wear the set of brightness. That said that nobody soon and he is a shirt of brightness, a cloth of brightness. It is the imaginations of the heart. It is what we are saying and then we are doing. He will wear that shirt. And then his enemy will say that, will cry that we have God. God is not with the pride one. It is not you that caused it. Concerning the will of God, if God give you long life, rejoice in the Lord and then humble yourself. Even if God give you the property of this world, you have to rejoice in him. And then you have to know that there is an enemy that hates your glory. But they don't have any power to do good. They have the power of destruction. Now, if they want to do good, it is impossible. Such a people are in this world. That is the reason why God said that we should be wise. Who knows that God has given David a crown? And then the king of that city Saul, he saw it. And he called him and he gave him his daughter to be a wife. That he will honor him in addition.
And kit me in do a typical of Vinny Biga Yagan.
And then they allowed them to build a story building whereby David and his doctor lived there. And one evening he ordered for his servant to go and bring David so that he will kill him. But it is God who has already honored David. That he will be a king. And then King Saul said that he also will honor David. Look at the kind of honor that God gave to David and that one of Saul, and know that is the honor of God and that of a human being the same. What is this teaching you? If the honor of a man and that of God is not the same, if people begin to mock at you, don't look at them, don't expect them to honor you. They are the one who can raise you up, and they are the one who can even though the honor of a woman being doesn't long. If he honor you and then you give him something and then you change, he will change. Have you seen?
Don't you come here to win a war David?
Here we have seen that how God honored David.
That's how you near thing and you can yet bumming a war on them.
And Saul and his the entire city said that they also will honor David.
Bumming on the river that.
Immediately their own fell.
You don't tell what to cook.
And then they wanted to kill David.
The modern is a jolly.
And so that the ground will consume him.
He shall walk here, sir.
Look at the kind of honor that is from a woman. It is death. Even till now, if people together elect a president, and then he will be a president with joy, and they will allow him to swear that he will handle the country, and then he will swear in no time to begin to critique him. What is he saying? What is he doing?
No, katatun yamie.
He doesn't please us.
Tunundayak fo.
We are the one who have elected
me.
But we want you to vanish.
Fulka.
We want you to leave.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Inshallah yakri.
If human being elect you.
When yakri kweka.
If God elect you, you don't have any problem.
I'm talking about when I'm yakri.
We supposed to hold on the elect of God.
I am zamsha.
And then led.
Nil kami wor hanwa por yambira sami.
If someone who doesn't know how to honor you begin to mock at you, don't be disappointed.
But I need misa zabiarse.
God, there is people that is fighting unnecessarily.
Mam katinya foro mama.
I cannot see how they were
Yad,
and then you begin to mock at
me.
No, I will not allow it. Don't play with me.
Fuka tia tumbiga.
You cannot be a servant.
Mwa kinwa madam mamzaki.
And then you want to work like
mam
a madam
pasak,
in the house. I don't accept it.
Hey. Dabo wogol wogol hanka.
We should not look for Anna where there is not there.
Fondik tumne bigeta wa foma ya.
Have you taken the servant and you want him to honor you?
Awo amala.
Are you sure that you have already honored his mother?
Yes,
it begins there.
The way it was,
and then you said that he should honor you.
Katua.
It is difficult.
And the them
if he have to bend down and greet his mother in
La Peter Mawanida and TM the needle la awa damawana
and cleaning and washing the slippers of his mother.
And I'm man for me.
He will do the same to you.
He didn't
do it there.
When
you call him, he will come and then stand before you. What are you asking me to do for you? Praise the Lord.
You
can call someone.
Tasak fam.
And he will answer.
You can king fam.
And he will not go.
Unkoshi.
And then he will keep long.
Tu voulais pas deuxième.
And then they will call him the second
time.
Did you hear that I'm calling you? I have heard you.
Mwatame.
I am coming.
Le parfum.
And then he will be quiet.
You know.
And in no time again.
Troisième.
The third one.
And you go by at all.
That answer will be different. That is with answer.
Don't
play with me.
Balakuna ma.
Praise the Lord.
Therefore,
we supposed to be very careful that we will not look for respect where there is no
nothing.
You have to be careful with how you want people to respect you. It is not everyone who have the teachings to respect their masters. To respect their pastors. To respect their adversaries.
Ayo.
No.
It
is not everyone who had that teachings. Some of them had that the teachings. If you see that someone have called you,
that's
and if he's older than you, if you get there, you have to bend down. Only this. If the one who called him, I was angry with him. And he
have
seen that the one who came, he bent down himself to listen to him. He will humble his voice. And then he will advise him. He will not insult him no more. But it is the way he bent himself that allow the anger to change. Meaning that people who are looking at their children in such manner are looking for peace for them in the future. So that every kind of house can handle them. Because they have put in them the spirit of humility. Have you seen? In our old time, they were given the women. Someone was having one doctor. And then he gave him more juju to be like a man. And then no man can able to defeat her. Forgetting that she will not remain with you. So he was given to a man that is a boxer. And then one day the man stood up to fight against the woman. And then because the doctor didn't want to fight with the man, he went home. And then he followed the girl on the road. And then beating the woman. And then the wife didn't see anything. Instantly he turned away and then he held the man. And then the man was discouraged. Because that kind of power that is in the life of his wife. Because his father gave her more juju. And then he lifted the man up and saying, it is because I want to respect my parents. That is the reason why I kept quiet and looking at you. Otherwise, you can't do nothing. But I don't want them to disrespect
me. And then
he shook the man and then put him down silently.
That
was the end of the fight.
If
it happened that it is today our young girls who have that kind of strength, they will maltreat you.
For
you go home with a piece of cloth. Are we seeing?
Don't think you know
in man. No, we are a generation. We are in a generation where
we have more compatibility.
You're supposed to feed them. All the most important is you to feed them so that they will not be angry. Meanwhile, God who created a human being. There is a prophet more than eating. There is a prophet more than eating. But we are only handling the child so that he will not. He will not be disappointed. So that he will always put on a good cloth. Whether he have a good wisdom, good mind or not, it doesn't matter. Have you seen? One of our pastors went to the house of one lady.
Maybe Puaka Akatal Sida Latara Bipula.
That lady don't have a husband, but she had a doctor.
Bamzi Shong Roto.
As they were sitting down and then talking.
Bipula Jim Matel Yamrabala.
His doctor was sitting down crying. And then he asked her,
Madam, Yablam began to tell Yamro to
Madam, what is the reason why your doctor is crying?
Alata Yamba.
He loves you.
Did go, Madam, why you can't tell?
And then he said, hey, Madam, if it is so, it is impossible.
Yamba ended.
Have you seen?
Shah Hashabi.
But that was the end of that conversation. We have to take them. Otherwise, there's no profit. If you don't teach your child, in the future, you will be like someone who is putting on a piece of clothes. Because of the life of your child. You're supposed to humble yourself and teach him. David was the one who acknowledged the blessings of God. He said that God have honored him and have given him a kingship. And he
have
blessed him forever. Have given him happiness. And he said, I lay on you. Meaning that if you lay on someone, you depend on someone. And if he fails, you too, you fail. That is, we call laying on someone. In our ancestors were friends to them together. Then he will listen to the voice of his friend. And then he will see his works. Meaning, and then he will see that it is someone that you can rely on. And then they will friend to that one. And then they will depend on him. That is what our ancestors used to be friends. Those are people are looking for a woman to be their wife. But it has a profit. If in the time of trouble, as you have seen that his friend is right and then he depends on him. If the friend didn't send someone to come and save him, he himself will come and defend him. King David lay on God, he depends on God. We have walked to into a generation. There is a few people that you can depend or lay on them without putting into shame. It is not good for someone to not have anyone that you can depend on. Means that if you are not right, someone cannot lay or depend on you. If he lay himself on you in the time of trouble, he will be put into shame. But with someone, he will see that there is nothing in it. As he knows that you depend on him, he himself will come voluntarily. I am in a situation. But in my heart, if not you, I don't see anyone.
Then
I have come for you to save, to help me. If the one that you depend on is a right, he also will depend on another just man. And what you have told him, as you don't have, he will go and then and told someone that he trusts. And those two people will resolve your problem. And then you will not be put into shame. Because you lay or you depend on two just people. But if you lay on each other that is not able to defend you, knowing that if you lay on him and when he fell, you too will fail. Don't you know that the falling will bring worries in your life? It is you who caused that. You have to look for just people so that in the time of
Shanta
difficulties, then they will save you.
There
is so people who depend on some useless people.
So in the
time of trouble, they went to them thinking that maybe they can help them.
And then
they will begin to
speak their face
and say that, oh, I don't have
anything.
It is not that I don't want to help you, but I don't
have anything.
That man, as he wake up from there,
that
was the end of his
dependence.
That was the end of
that person. To
take it out of his
heart. I thought
he was a just
one.
This is happening to people.
Dime David de la Wende.
Our King David rely on God.
Someone
cannot trust God and then will
people.
He said so and then it is written
so.
He who trusts God will not be ashamed. It is not that there is no shame.
Who reject shame
to those who trust him.
Praise
the Lord. Let's trust God.
If
you trust yourself, your worries will not end.
The
King David said,
because
you have unshakable
love, I
will trust my God. I will not doubt about my God.
Because
the one that I trust, if he said that he loved
you, his
love is unshakable.
Because
of that unshakable, it will chase away fears. If you lay on something and then that thing is shaking, you don't trust that one that you lay on.
And the
King David said,
those
who trust in God,
you
have to, there is no worry.
Because
God is unshakable. He is God. If you see someone who trusts God and then he is shaking,
because those who thought
that God is shaking,
It is possible
for them to go and see some juju people.
Because they
will enter into idolatries.
Because
they are doubting about God.
But
God doesn't receive such an
honor.
God will separate himself from such fellow.
And then he
will let him know that he don't depend on him.
It
is because of his doubting.
It
is because of his fear.
If you
don't have a good faith,
it will
prevent you from the help of God.
Because
God is not like a human being.
A human being,
you can say that you love him.
And
then he will believe.
But
God have two kinds of things that he look on.
As you
said that you trust him,
he will
listen to your word.
And then
look at into your
heart. And
then look at your work.
And then
they will judge your
dependence.
Where your trust, the limit of your
trust.
If you know that you don't trust him,
God will be
quiet looking at you.
Hati for yamawa ipukui.
Even till one day you know that you know it.
And then you
will see that it is only God that can save you.
Yampende.
Have you seen?
Mampami nyam shintinwina matura bien bini yambaye.
I don't know how you are serving, you trust in God and then you are still afraid.
La bema hambit yam yede. agida da wena mgate shong
yama. If there is fear in your heart, in your life, or that fear prevents you from reaching out to God.
Agida da.
Well, it prevents.
Na yam ha it ad wena ya wen.
And whenever you say that God is
la
God.
La dunia fam mpele ben nitiyer da tute anka yamba.
In this world, I don't see anyone that can be trusted apart from you.
Adam wumnam.
He here.
Abna antika fo vim.
And he will change your life.
Tiyer rimanda sobo.
That is what trusting God can cause.
There
were one king,
and you called
him Nebuchadnezzar.
When
God sent someone with dream
to
go and tell him
that
he should humble himself
and
do good
so that
God can help him.
He
gave him the dream, and then he gave another one a revelation.
When the word
of God said that one day he stood up on his tallest building and began to look at the territory of his city. He was alone. He was alone. And he began to see the greatness of the city.
It's
not good to imagine
that.
Evil imagination can damage people.
Yeah,
it is
an
evil imagination condemned that man.
And
even till now, evil imagination brings sickness, death, in the life of a woman being. If someone is filled with evil imaginations, with worries, if he went and then he passed and do some
vaccination, I
do some tests, so as the worries is working with the
blood,
that test will not produce good results.
The test
will prove that his blood is not
good.
Not knowing that it is because of his evil
imagination. That
it is worries that can damage your blood.
And then we
will go to pass on some tests, and then that test will bring fear into our life.
And then
we will only think about death.
In that
time, the demons of death will come.
What I am
telling
you, it is only God
that can reveal this,
so that you
will see the question, the reason why people blood are getting.
The
one who have given us the blood is the same one that can show us how our blood system is getting corrupt.
It
is out of the life of that one. If there is a lot of worries in his
life, and then
let him go and pass some tests. He have so many sicknesses.
Because
the evil imaginations will capture some sickness into his
life.
Rely on God and stop worrying.
Do
you
understand each other?
That is where we base on and thank God for this revelation.
Because
you have helped us,
and we are
in the salvation.
This man can
look at this generation.
If we haven't had
any
challenges,
and the world is getting to the end,
and
we cannot climb to heaven,
what are
we going to do?
If not because
we have that salvation,
you
don't have to play with it.
If
you play with
the
angel that will be sent from heaven to come and save the safe one, your own angel will not come.
Because
you are imagining here, and then it is writing in
heaven.
And you are working here, and they are writing it in heaven.
You are
speaking here, and they are writing it in heaven.
And
then they will judge.
Is it
true that this one can come to heaven?
Have
you seen? There is a judgment there.
tebet no ha ne ngom la atare manso mino yokati wa paradis.
And they said, no, the kind of life that you have and then the kind of where that you used to do, and you come to heaven.
Anandira
matin. Because he will dirty the place.
Ayo la nimni timi pam fanga le kom fanro.
That is the reason why someone can be saved and then lost it again.
You are
called to stop what you have and listen to God.
And
you separated yourself from hearing the word of God and you are doing your own
will. And
your will cannot take you to heaven.
For man of men.
You are the one who calls it.
It
is the will of God that can take someone to heaven. Praise the Lord. God loves us. And though he revealed to us how we would do to get to him. Together, let's praise God. In the, during the week, God has protected us.
He
has saved us from accidents. And then save us from the sickness of tension. The demons killing people. God has totally saved us. But it is not only you.
La mame.
And with me also.
Balkunama.
Praise the Lord.
Balkunama.
Let's thank God.
Our
faithful God which is in heaven. We thank you very much.
We praise
your
name.
You are the mighty one. We thank you, Jesus,
for
what you have done for us.
We thank you
for your kindness.
We
thank you for your goodness.
We
thank you for your love.
Nyam ya nimba jot. Shiru nam no wonam. Pangola wa no wonam. Benam pushi la baraka. Benam ferilam. Aje jila shori. Et word ilam. Et jek da di yu. Aje di adim. Ya far adim. Ya yon shori ma. Ferda di ma shenvia. Word ilam nam ferdia. Nyam ya kasanga. Yam
together we are going to thank God.
Songo la gurum ninga wena mtu Burkina Faso yinga.
For the help and protection that God is doing in Burkina Faso.
Na pusa wena baraka.
Let's thank God.
Tengalam pang hanse.
Because if the people of this city lack strength.
Pangato yid ajanawa.
A different strength will come from above.
Tontala shikuri.
We have a spare strength.
The tengalam katu yingi damatu yinga.
So if the people of this country are not able, the heavens will be able to. Let's thank God. Because of the peace and protection of our country. Our faithful God is powerful. We thank you very much, Father. We praise your name for our country. We lift up your name higher because, Father, we have seen your love and your protection, your care for us.
Our faithful God.
It is a man and a woman who together.
Tiam yelem tibi ni shama torchin tas.
That you said that this will be a good, righteous ones.
Ob chelra David vimati kibale.
They have listened to the life of David.
Mikta David da nungayama pu di baraka.
I realize that David loved you and thanked you.
La bamme wa shora zugu.
And they also have come unto that way.
La mtabam pu di baraka.
Together they are thanking you.
Because
you are protecting their houses.
And
then guarding their life.
And then you
have getting enough for
to feed themselves. And then
they are going out and coming in
peacefully.
You have prevented their house from thieves to enter.
te biete pushi baraka.
And they said they will thank you.
Rigene ba barak pus.
Receive the thanksgiving of their people.
Rigene ba perle.
Receive their praise.
Nyamsuma neba nira.
Because you have do good to them.
Igite ka kum jindamba.
You have prevented the spirit of
demon. Igite nyende.
And you have prevented a shame into their life.
Bire barak pus.
Receive the thanksgiving.
Nyam fanga neba.
Because you are saving your people.
Ni shutana jindam shonga.
From the destruction of the demons.
Ni shutana jindam shumpura.
With the anger of the demons.
Obunda tirwenga.
Because they thought evil,
you have
changed it unto good.
Change
it unto a blessing. Receive your praises.
Because you
are protecting yourself by
your own.
And then feeding them.
And
helping them. Receive your glory. Your
blessing.
Because they have abandoned and abandoned
idolatry.
And then abandoned idolatries. Because the old ways of their
ancestors.
And then they trust in you. And then they are sleeping in peace. They are sleeping in peace. But it is by your grace. They are happy.
To be able to push baraka.
And they said they will thank you. Because the country that they have
been,
that they have seen your protection. They have seen your protection.
Burkina Faso yinga.
In Burkina Faso.
Jinina amajire zugu.
You are sit on your throne.
Ndiye bara pusho ti mwango.
Receive your glory as a sacrifice.
Tenga lafi yinga.
For the peace of the country.
Tenga gudum yinga.
For the protection of the country.
Ya neji ndara jim.
It is with the sharing of the blood.
And victory.
That is leading.
Bara pusho kapwa.
That thanksgiving.
Bilie pierre.
Receive your praise.
Tima na Burkina Faso
ni. You have done good to Burkina Faso.
Ikitam te tenga yala katen.
You allow the country to enlarge.
Ili lekdame yunu kudame.
You are feeding them and you are giving them water to drink.
Tidi baraka.
Then we are saying thank you.
Ihim fanga tenga.
Because you have saved the country.
Ni yel biel bud fan.
From all evil.
Tumna malakramba.
You send your angels.
Mwin untola yungo.
Day and night.
Burkina Faso yor so yinga.
For the peace of Burkina Faso.
Malakrama manda tumde.
The angels are doing their works.
La ne pu huna baraka.
And we will thank you, Lord.
Ajizi uralu tenga yinga.
For the name of Jesus Christ who covered the world.
Ajizi masuminga.
In the name of Jesus.
Amina.
Amen.